Hello, this is Dennis with A1 Telephone Service and Repair, A1 Electronics. You can get us on the web at www.a1-telephone.com, and you can also reach us at 618-235-6959. Today I want to show you an animated Mickey Mouse telephone that Monica sent in from South Carolina. And basically the problem with this is the initial check out of this telephone, is the head does not rock back and forth in the animation. And the other part that rocks back and forth is the hand that kind of like rubs over his belly or whatever. But basically, sometimes these will break. These are always a lot of fun to take apart. You have to take this Mickey totally apart to get to the inside, so everything has to come apart. And I just have his body right now put back together. I just have it sitting there in the head. But basically everything has to come totally apart, and even the base, because you have to get into the base to get Mickey off of the base of the telephone. And so a lot of times what will happen is they'll break in different places, sometimes the gears or the motor. It just all depends. But sometimes people will equate the springs, because these are spring-loaded, with the problem, and that it's just a spring that's off. And it's never the spring, really. What happens is, I'll show you, sometimes the gears will break or a motor will burn out or something. But as you can see this rock back and forth, really all the spring does in the arm and the head is keep the tension on the oblong gear here. And as you can see me rocking that back and forth, you can see his hand moving back and forth. And so the spring is really nothing more than to keep it tight against the oblong gear. And anyway, the guy on this Mickey right here would be his head. His head would sit right in here and it bolts in all together. And you have your guide here that runs along that oblong gear, and basically it's broke. Now I've seen them break here. I've repaired a lot of these through the years, and you can take this basically and sometimes, and I'll make a decision when I go ahead and repair it, whether I should put a sleeve on here or maybe even put another piece on, and it'll be designed just like the guide that's on there now. It'll just be a different one. So whatever, when I get a better look at it, I'll make that decision. But anyway, we'll get it all back together again. The hook switch in these are a real pain to work on too, because it's a dual hook switch. It's an odd size, and you really can't find it anywhere. I've rebuilt quite a few of these hook switches in my day, and if you have never rebuilt a hook switch in one of these, that's a lot of fun. So, you know, give it a try sometime. Anyway, here's a good look at your motor and your gears. And you got your worm gear there on your motor, but everything has to come totally apart. So it's pretty exciting to take all this apart. Even though I've worked on a whole bunch of these and repaired them, you forget about all the things that have to come apart to get into the insides of him. So, and there's all types of different animated phones that we work on here. So none of them are exactly the same. There's always something different to each one of them. But this is the initial checkout of this Mickey, and he looks like he's totally fallen apart today. But actually, he's going to get repaired, and we'll get him back to Monica, and they'll be happy to get Mickey back and in working condition. The spring does come off after parts break. Because basically the spring is attached, and that's what makes this a weak point here on this guide. What happens is there's a little hole here, and they put some hot glue on there to keep it together and keep the spring in there. And basically when they did that, they kind of shot themselves in the foot in the engineering department when they designed this, because what happens is you have quite a bit of pressure on this guide here, and they don't give you much material here, so it's really not all that sturdy. And if Mickey falls off a table, or you know, his head gets slammed a little bit, or his arm, what happens is that guide breaks right off because there's a hole drilled in there, which made it weak. So it made a weak point. So basically when I repair these, I've done numerous different types of repairs on these, and whatever I come up with at the time, because each one's a little different, we always end up putting the spring back, but we design it a little differently so that we don't have that weak point there. And under normal use, you'll never have to worry about it again. But of course, just like anything else, if it, you know, takes a fall for a good little distance, or you know, the head gets slapped somehow, then yeah, there's a possibility it'll break again, because you know, we're just dealing with plastic here, and it's not going to take any, you know, kind of a real good fall, or you know, if somebody gets rough with it or something. Sometimes kids will get rough with these and they'll break them, so just depends. But under normal use, it shouldn't, you know, shouldn't be a problem. Anyway, this is a initial checkout of a animated Mickey Mouse telephone, and we're going to get this taken care of, and I'll try to do a second video of it. I'll just have to see how it goes. But this is Dennis with A1 Telephone Service and Repair, A1 Electronics. You can get us on the web at www.a1-telephone.com, and you can also reach us at 618-235-6959. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.